This is an MMA contest scheduled for 3 4-minute rounds for the vacant CSFC Bantamweight title. Would you welcome to the cage first, from Morecambe MMA, Kieran And now, would you welcome to the cage his opponent from AVT Dewsbury, Gaz, the Angry introducing to you firstly in the blue corner, wearing blue shorts trimmed with black and white. He weighed in at 61 kilograms. From Morecambe MMA, Kieran O'Brien. And his opponent across the cage in the red corner, wearing black compression shorts. He too weighed in at 61 kilos. From AVT Dewsbury, Gaz, the Angry Fan! Your referee when the action gets underway is Craig Lawrence. This is 3 4-minute rounds of MMA for the vacant CSFC Bantamweight title.
So as you heard, the bantamweight title at stake. And Jay, it really is a clash of styles. You've got Gaz Firm, 4-0, short, muscular. Kieran O'Brien, tall, leaner, both dead on 61K.
Yeah, definitely a clash of styles physically, and a clash of styles in terms of how these guys are going to approach this fight.
Big left hand there immediately from Gaz Firm. And he says he likes to entertain, he likes to get in there, he likes to fight. He actually does like to get angry in the cage.
Yeah, and he's straight away got a good hold of Kieran O'Brien there, and he's worked that knee through to the mount position. This is not a great start for O'Brien.
Because we did feel that he would try to keep it upright and maybe stick and move and keep some distance between them, didn't we?
Yeah, from the past times I've seen O'Brien fight, you know, he's very elusive. Almost Dominic Cruz-esque at times, you know, hits a move, gets his shots off. And, you know, Gaz is the total opposite. You know, he plunders forward and he tries to grab a hold of you and he tries to lay lever on you. And he's managed to work to his game plan early on.
Yeah, he's looking to posture up now, get work done. And O'Brien keeping him in tight there.
He's got the kind of the body shape, the body type to have an effective guard, you know, the long limbs, and as you can see there, he really tries to work his legs up, but Gaz is up and out of there. Makes sense not to engage in that guard, some heavy
punches.
There was
a big right hand that landed in there, Jay. The first right hand was the one that really landed.
And he likes the success with that as he tries it again, comes past with a big right hand and gets past the guard.
And that right hand is the danger here for Kieran O'Brien. And he comes through the channel again.
Yeah, and effective using that big right hand to pass the guard as well, killing two birds with one stone. And he managed to, he's on top of O'Brien, but O'Brien's got that knee in, using them long limbs to just try and keep Firm at bay a little bit.
We can hear the crowd's response to this opening from Gaz Firm. As I said, he is a crowd pleaser. He's 4-0 at the moment. Got back from Thailand over Christmas, training there. In great shape for this fight.
Yeah, he's a very physical bantamweight fighter. And he uses a lot of that athleticism here, and he's very powerful as well. We can hear the thud of those right hands as they connect.
Now from the back of the hall, it might seem that a lot more of those right hands are landing, but O'Brien does block a good percentage of them.
Yeah, he's very wily, is O'Brien. You know, limbs everywhere. He's not letting Gaz pass through and solidify a good top position. You know, he's doing an understated job, but he's doing a good job of just keeping Firm at bay.
But as we've mentioned before, it is, until this point, a defensive job, which doesn't score for you.
It's keeping him in a fight, but it's not necessarily winning him a fight.
And that's the mobility you talked of and that movement. The lateral movement of O'Brien there. And the jab from Southpaw snakes it out and then moves laterally again. This is more the fight you thought you'd see from him, Jay.
Yeah, we've seen both guys employing the tactics in to some degree. A nice right hand landed there from O'Brien. Definitely wants to keep this more at distance and use his length.
Oh, big right hand though.
Gaz Firm teeing off. That was a heavy right hand that clubbed O'Brien. And he looks a bit shaky, but comes back with that loose jab there.
Yes, he smiles at Gaz Firm, but that was a heavy, heavy bombardment he took.
And Gaz dives in and gets that takedown again on the fence. And there's not long left in this first round. But that's, he's got to put a statement on the round for Gaz Firm.
Yes, big right hand in that round towards the end, really set up that finish. But it was a fast start as well, wasn't it? So when you look, when you're a judge, you're looking at the beginning and looking at the end, all you see is Gaz Firm.
Yeah, we've seen glimpses of what O'Brien can do, but Firm definitely dictated the round. He's landed some heavy shots standing and on the ground, and he's got to be happy with that performance in the round. O'Brien can be buoyed a little bit by some of the success when he got on his feet. He landed some nice front kicks, you know, sort of almost Anderson Silva-esque. but then Thurman walked through him and, you know, threw some bombs of his own. And if O'Brien stays in that range with Firm, then expect him to eat some more shots like that.
Well, we did say when we were discussing this fight that you said to me, Firm will take shots, you can't hit him to deliver his own work.
Yeah, definitely, and we saw that. It worked, he ate some shots to get on the inside, and he'll have to do that again because O'Brien uses his reach well and he moves well. You've got to be quite happy to take some to get on the inside of this guy.
So, nod, they touch gloves and they go again, and immediately Gaz Firm wants to get on that inside. Movement again from O'Brien, but Firm gets there. He's got the single leg.
Yep, and maybe looking for an omoplata there is O'Brien on the bottom. He jumped it, but I don't think he wants to get stuck on the bottom. Not again. We saw what happened in that first round.
It was a risky tactic, and he might have to pay for that now.
Gaz has got the pass there. Nice and heavy with the hips, trying to crunch O'Brien up. Yeah, and get that dominant position. O'Brien, it's not going to be a comfortable position.
And again, the heavy leather attempts from Gaz Firm.
Yeah, Gaz, he doesn't throw any pawing shots. Everything is, you know, thrown to knock you out.
And from the glimpses we've seen, I really feel O'Brien would be better served on his feet and moving and trying to keep the distance. He showed some good lateral movement in the first round, but not enough of it.
Yeah, and Firm, he's a very fit guy as well. He'll keep coming at you for the duration of the fight if you let him. He won't slow down, he's non-stop. I'm sure O'Brien's got cardio himself.
Oh, he felt that right hand though, Jay. He felt that right hand.
And Gaz senses some blood. He's swarming on O'Brien. O'Brien's done a good job there and stayed in the fight. What a tough guy.
Yes, but the referee looking closely now as Gaz Firm throws that leather. He's looking for the arm, O'Brien. It slips free again, and instead he ships more leather from the relentless Gaz Firm. He's got to be careful here. No, the ref. You look at O'Brien, he's saying, no, I was fine. But then he passed the ref to say, it's got to be intelligent defence, hasn't it, Jay?
Yeah, definitely. He was eating a lot of punches there. He didn't seem to be escaping the position. And whilst he still had his wits about him, the key word is intelligent defence. And remember, these guys are still amateur fighters. They're fighting for a title. They're very good amateur fighters. But fighter safety's got to be the main concern. And it appears O'Brien realises that now.
Yes, he immediately patted the ref afterwards to say, yep, I understand. Good call. And explosive while it lasted, but Gaz Firm, he had a game plan and he stuck to it brilliantly.
Yeah, definitely, and he was relentless with what he wanted to do, and some of that ground and pound coming in was vicious, and there is no doubt O'Brien will be feeling some bumps and bruises in the morning.
Ladies and gentlemen, could you please show your appreciation for both fighters? Also, will you please put your hands together to welcome to the cage, to make the belt presentation, the one and only Alex Reed! The contest came to an end after 1 minute and 56 seconds of round number two. Your winner by TKO and new CSFC Bantamweight champion from ABT Dewsbury, Gaz the Angry Firm! Will you please continue your applause for a gallant opponent from Morecambe MMA, Kieran?
And with CSFC Bantamweight champion Gaz Firm. How does that feel, Gaz? Champion.
Yeah, amazing. Been waiting a long time. It's been a tough camp. I've had a lot of kind of injuries and controversy, going different places, and a lot's come up in this fight camp, but I've always stayed like true to what I'm about. Hard work, good work ethic in gym, always pushing myself, doing them extras, and it's paid off today.
Now, you knew what type of fighter he was, and you adapted your game plan. You didn't give him any room to breathe, and it paid off for you.
Yeah, I kind of fight like that all the time. I knew that he's got good long kicks, he's a rangy guy, he's a lot taller than me, as most are. But I knew if I got an inside, I've got heavy hands, I can wrestle. And I knew if I'd got an inside, I'm going to hurt him. I hurt him a few times, and fair play to the kid. He took a good shot, a few good shots, and he kept going. And I thought I'd put him out a few times, he kept going. It was awesome. Did really well. And thank you to Kieran for giving me the opportunity to fight him. And cheers to CSFC.
Well, it's another explosive performance. You're 5-0, you're the champion. Well done, guys.
Thank you very much. Cheers.